Tell me something that crosses your mind when you think of Đắk Lắk. Elephants? Ethnic minorities? Still houses? Well, if that is the case, you are dead wrong. Now, let me show you something that could possibly blow your mind. Take a look at these scenes. Picturesque landscape, exquisite flowers, and romantic settings. Do they remind you of Đắk Lắk? Sorry, that's not the answer that you're waiting for. Welcome to Đắk Lắk, or Buôn Ma Thuột City. A green city with lots of tree-lined streets, nice houses, fantastic food, and exciting tourist attractions. If you've never been here, you must be thinking, it is a poor, sleepy little town, but it's not. In this video, I'm gonna give you some insider tips to help you have a better option when you pay a visit to Đắk Lắk. But first, how do you get here? Well, you can book a flight if money is no object to you. But if you're traveling on a budget, taking a sleeper bus will definitely be a better option. It's about 6 to 7 hour ride, so it's best to buy a night bus ticket. There are four main categories that I wanna highlight in this clip. First of all, the weather. The weather here is kind of unpredictable. It's not cold all year round like Đắk Lắk. Sometimes you can experience four seasons in a day. The average temperature is around 26 to 28 degrees, but at some point, it may drop to even 19 degrees, so make sure you have some warm clothes in your backpack for safe bets. Second of all, the food. This is probably one of the best parts of Đắk Lắk. You can find an abundance of great dishes here. The good news is, I have compiled a list of fine dining establishments where you can try them. And if you are a foodie, these two dining establishments are highly recommended. I think they're also a must-go for every first-time visitor. Number 1. Mitter Beef Steak. On the outside, this restaurant looks rather small and dull, but on the inside, it's a lot nicer and more spacious. The servers here are really polite and attentive. The menu is also great. It has a variety of choices and most of the dishes taste wonderful. A few dishes are a little pricey, but in my opinion, they're worth the price. Your top choice should be the black pepper seafood spaghetti. It is by far the best one that I've ever had. Well, this dining establishment can be considered the most popular place for those who are into Western cuisine. As you can see, today is the fifth day of Tết and it's also packed with customers. Number 2. Bánh nước 45. Bánh nước is a kind of steamed, thin rice pancake, and this place offers a unique dish that you probably cannot find in Ho Chi Minh City. In other words, it's one of the local specialties here. With an excellent taste and a budget-friendly price, it's easy to understand why this place is usually packed with customers. However, if you're starving, do not come here. It can make you hangry. In case you are not familiar with this dish, here's how you should eat it. And this was how much we had to pay after finishing more than 30 plates. Just a little reminder that this place only opens after 2 p.m. Also, if you can't stand the smell of mom name, then sorry, this dish isn't for you. Here is a list of dishes that you should try when you get here, together with the address. Obviously, their quality depends on people's preferences. You can take a screenshot to save it to your phone. Third of all, places of interest. Go Tam Ecological Tourist Area. This is no doubt my favorite place in Đắk Lắk. I've been here 3 times and I always left this place happily. It has a lot of stunning landscapes with bamboo-lined paths, flower-lined paths, an artificial waterfall, and so much more. For me, it's like a smaller version of Đà Lạt with flowers in every nook and cranny. The food in this place in general is quite good and the prices are reasonable. You can sit in the shade, enjoying your meals if you like. What's more, Prices don't go up even in high season, which is awesome. Plus, it's really close to the city center, so it should be the first place on your list. Chobu Ecological Tourist Area. And if you are interested in some fun activities instead of just enjoying the flowers, pay a visit to Chobu. This is a brand new place, even for the local. I had a whale of a time here. However, it's kind of far from the downtown area, and the weather here is really sunny. So my advice is to come here after 8 a.m. If you're a history person, drop by Daklak Museum. It shows you all the ancient history of the city. Unfortunately, the museum was closed when I was here, so I couldn't go inside. But on the outside, it is a vast area surrounded by a lot of big trees, which makes this an extremely windy place. So girls, you don't have to worry about the sunlight when you get here. There used to be two colossal trees here, but sadly, one just died a few years ago, and now there's only one left. If you're into visiting pagodas, or you're traveling with your parents, Kaiduang is a pagoda that you shouldn't miss. It's in fact the biggest one in Bumathut. Even though it's a sacred place, its scenery is wonderful. You can snap some great shots here with your travel buddies. At nightfall, you can go to the walking street and take loads of beautiful photos to make your friends jealous. As you can probably guess, this place perfectly fits those who enjoy having stunning pictures on Facebook. I'm sure it'll give you a hard time choosing which pictures you should post and which you shouldn't. Fourth of all, cafes. As you probably know, Daklak has long been reputable for its coffee. In fact, there are a multitude of nice cafes here, and I'll try my best to take you to some of the nicest ones during my time of stay. Chungwing Coffee Village. This vast area is definitely a worth visiting destination for any first-time visitors. It is indeed a really cool and windy place. You can enjoy the coffee both indoors and outdoors with your travel partners and admire its fantastic view. And if you like, you can even drink coffee in the cave while listening to the sound of water streaming right next to you. It promises to be an unforgettable experience. Be mindful that the coffee here is kind of pricey, but since the view is good, it's kind of makes up for the price. Suvanay Cafe. As its name speaks for itself, this cafe is a great combination of the old and new. It gives you a nostalgic feeling right after you walk in. What's more, it's an airy and spacious place so you can feel the cool breezes blowing into almost every corner of the cafe. You can also watch and feed the fish, the squirrels, and have some relaxing time with the swim. However, the toilet here is a minus. It's not very clean. If Suvanay Cafe is not much of a novelty, try this. Having coffee in a still house will be bound to give you a brand new experience. There are a wide range of cafes here with similar architecture, so pick one at your leisure. I don't know about you, but I myself don't really enjoy the drinks here. Yet if you go for the experience, it's worth it. And guys, pay attention to this. Daklak girls are really pretty.